My name is Allison Jessing, and I'm the head of adult curriculum at Howard County Library System. Thank you for joining us today. Howard County Library System and the Howard County Health Department are partnering to bring you virtual presentations about important health topics. Today, our guest is Kirsten Miner, community health educator at the Howard County Health Department. Kirsten will be sharing information on the COVID-19 vaccine. Please check the video description for links to the resources and websites that we mentioned today. Kirsten, thanks for joining us, and I will turn it over to you.
Hello, Howard County, and thank you for joining the Howard County Health Department for a discussion around COVID-19 and the COVID-19 vaccine. Please note that this information is current as of January 19th of 2021. As information continues to rapidly evolve, to stay up to date, please follow us at HOCO Health on social media. We can be found on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We also invite you to sign up for regular communication at hchealth.org. So what is known about COVID-19? Well, infection with SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, can result in a range of illness from mild symptoms to severe illness and death. We don't know how SARS-CoV-2 will affect each person, but we do know that some people, such as adults 65 and older, or people with certain medical conditions are more likely than others to become severely ill. Common symptoms of COVID-19 include cough, fever, new loss of taste or smell, shortness of breath, or difficulty breathing. Some individuals may also be asymptomatic, meaning they show no signs of symptoms of illness. However, they are still contagious and could spread COVID-19. So how exactly is COVID spread? We know that COVID-19 spreads very easily from person to person. It's most commonly spread through close contact and exposure to respiratory droplets. So when a person's infected with COVID-19, if they sneeze or cough, these respiratory droplets can be released from the nose or mouth when a person sneezes. And if you are in close contact with the person, if you were to inhale through the mouth or nose, those droplets, you may become infected. And even if a person, maybe they're asymptomatic, so they're not coughing or sneezing, even if you're in close contact with them, a person just simply breathing, seeing, you could still be exposed to respiratory droplets. So there's a lot of conversations around vaccines. And essentially vaccines were created and are recommended to reduce your risk for infection or severe illness caused by infection and to protect yourself and others. Examples of vaccines include the flu shot, measles, mumps, and rubella vaccine, a chickenpox, and a vaccine to prevent the human papillomavirus. The COVID-19 vaccine is an mRNA vaccine that has been created to prevent COVID-19 infection or to reduce your risk for severe illness from the disease if you are infected. So why should you consider getting vaccinated? Vaccine can prevent you from infection from COVID-19. It can reduce your severe illness from COVID-19 infection. It can protect you and others, and most importantly, it can help our communities, frontline healthcare workers, businesses, and schools as we hope to reopen in the future. So key facts about COVID-19 vaccination include, aside from again mentioning that getting vaccinated can help prevent getting sick with COVID, people who have already actually gotten sick with COVID-19 can still benefit from getting vaccinated. And please note, the COVID-19 vaccines cannot give you COVID-19, and the COVID-19 vaccines will not cause you to test positive on a COVID-19 viral test. You can find more information at cdc.gov as well. So there are different types of vaccines. As I previously mentioned, the two authorized vaccines are mRNA vaccines. mRNA vaccines contain non-infectious materials from a virus that provides instructions to our cells to create harmless protein unique to virus to promote an immune response that protects against future infections. These vaccines do not contain a live virus, nor do they cause a disease to incur in a vaccinated person. You also have protein subunit vaccines that include harmless protein pieces from a virus instead of the entire germ, which can promote an immune response. And last, you have vector vaccines that contain a weakened version of a live virus with genetic material that provides instructions to cells to create a protein which promotes an immune response. So even though mRNA vaccines are new, they're not unknown, and they have been studied for more than a decade. And please note, the COVID-19 vaccines are being held to the same safety standards as all vaccines that we are most common with. And please also note, there are systems in place that allow the CDC and FDA to watch for safety issues. And you can find more information by visiting cdc.gov and look for V-Safe. So how effective is the COVID-19 vaccine? Well, as I mentioned, so far there's two vaccines that have received emergency use authorization from the FDA. Those include the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine, which requires two doses 3 weeks apart and have been approved for use in individuals who are 16 years of age or older. And then you have your Moderna vaccine, which again requires two doses 4 weeks apart and have been approved for use in individuals 18 years and older. And please note, the FDA is continuing the process of evaluating other candidates for emergency use authorization. The Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine, the vaccine is reporting that it is 95% effective against COVID infection, while as the Moderna vaccine is reporting that it's 94.1% effective against COVID-19 infection with 100% effectiveness against severe illness from COVID-19. And you can read more about these vaccines and vaccine administration at coronavirus.maryland.gov. So common side effects from the COVID-19 vaccine include injection site pain or redness, fatigue, muscle or joint pain, or headache. There's a lot of questioning right now around, well, when can I be vaccinated? And please note that our vaccine prioritization may be subject to change, but currently the vaccine phases include 1A, which includes healthcare workers, residents and staff of nursing facilities, and first responders, as well as public safety and correction workers. Phase 1B includes individuals who reside in assisted living or other congregate settings, adults age 75 and older, and individuals who work in education, other forms of government. Phase 1C includes adults age 65 to 74, and essential workers in lab services such as agriculture, manufacturing, postal service, and so forth. And then phase 2 includes adults ages 16 to 64 who are at increased risk of severe COVID-19 illness due to an underlying medical condition. It also includes essential workers in critical utilities, transportation, food services. And phase 3 is when it'll be widely available to the general population, including healthy adults ages 16 to 64. So please visit hchealth.org to stay up to date on COVID-19 vaccine and priority group information to know when your priority group is next. And please note that our site is updated regularly to include updates about priority groups as they are announced from the state. When you visit hchealth.org, you may be asked to provide information by completing the survey to be added to our contact list. Please note that you will get a separate email with instructions for making an appointment and registration information as well. So when it's your time to get the vaccine, you may wonder, well, how much it will cost and where to go. So as more vaccines become available in a number of places that can give the vaccine increase, you'll have more options similar to same places you would go for your flu vaccine. The COVID-19 vaccine is free, but some vaccination providers will charge an administration fee for giving the shot to someone. And again, when the vaccine is available to the general public, you must register and you can visit hchealth.org. After you get the COVID-19 vaccine, we encourage individuals to still continue to follow COVID-19 prevention measures, and that includes covering your nose and mouth with a mask, stay at least 6 feet or more from people who do not live with you, avoid crowds and poorly ventilated spaces, wash your hands, and clean and disinfect frequently touched surfaces. Again, you can enroll and be safe. And if you have any questions about your health and vaccination, call your doctor, nurse, or clinic. Even if you've had the COVID-19 virus, you may wonder, do I still need to get vaccinated? And we say yes, because we don't know how long the antibodies last after COVID-19 infection and whether these antibodies will actually protect you from giving COVID-19 again. And due to the severe health risks associated with COVID-19, we still advise that the benefits of vaccination outweigh the risk. If you have allergies, you may wonder, can I get the vaccine? And the CDC recommends that people with a history of severe allergic reactions not related to vaccines or injectable medications, such as allergies to food, pet, venom, environmental, or latex, may still get vaccinated. People with a history of allergies to oral medications or a family history of severe allergic reactions, or who may have a milder allergy to vaccines, so no anaphylaxis, may also still get vaccinated. And even if, again, you have allergies, CDC recommends that if you have a history of severe allergic reaction after getting a shot, you should not get a second shot. Your doctor may refer you to a specialist in allergies and immunology to provide more care or advice. And all individuals who get the vaccine are monitored for at least 15 minutes, and people with a history of severe allergic reactions are monitored for at least 30 minutes after getting the vaccine. So until you can get the vaccine, here are a few things that you can continue to do. First, stay COVID safe. Again, cover your mouth, nose with a mask. Wash your hands often with soap and water, or use hand sanitizer with at least 60% alcohol. Stay at least 6 feet away from others. If you believe you've possibly been exposed to the virus and you feel under the weather, you can get tested. And again, avoid crowds and poorly ventilated spaces. You can get your vaccine when it comes available to you, and we encourage you, others to also get vaccinated. And again, stay connected with us and help others get connected too. You can stay up to date by again visiting us at HOCO Health or following us at HOCO Health on social media. You can also call us at 410-313-6284, or you can email us at axhealth@howardcountymd.gov.
Thank you, Kirsten, for all that wonderful information. Remember, folks, there are links in the description that will lead you to more information and resources. Take care and have a great day.